Hi, my name is Paul Offit. I'm talking to you today from the Vaccine Education Center here at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. I wanted to take a minute to talk about measles because of a surprising new finding. What we know about measles is we know it's a virus. We know that it's a virus that's contracted usually by coming in contact with small droplets from people who are sneezing or coughing or talking near you who have measles. We know that the virus can then enter the body, travel to the skin, and cause a rash. We know that the virus can travel to the lungs and cause pneumonia, which can be severe and occasionally fatal. We know that the virus can travel to the brain and cause something called encephalitis, which just means inflammation of the brain, which can be severe, debilitating, and occasionally fatal. What we didn't know until now, until a paper that just came out really in October of 2019 that was published in the medical journal Science, was what the virus can also do, what natural measles virus can also do, is it can eliminate previous immunological memory. So in other words, if you've been infected with a common cold virus, usually you're not going to get that common cold virus, that specific one again. If you've been vaccinated against diphtheria or tetanus or whooping cough or polio or pneumococcus or Haemophilus influenza B or all the vaccines that you get in the first few years of life, that this virus, this natural measles virus, can actually eliminate that memory. So it's as if you've never been vaccinated. Now, the vaccine virus doesn't do that. If you've gotten measles vaccine, which is part of the measles, mumps, rubella combination vaccine, the measles vaccine doesn't in any sense affect immunological memory. What it does is it provides immunological memory against measles. So the vaccine doesn't do it, but the natural virus can do it, which is why the natural virus is, in some ways is even more heinous than we'd originally imagined. Thank you.